السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، you guys still remember the month of Ramadan? Still remember the month of Ramadan? The memories are still fresh in your mind, right? Okay, so one thing that is very common in the month of Ramadan is what? Eating fresh dates. Now, how many of you, can you even remember how many dates you've eaten in Ramadan? Can you try even guess the count, how many of them, you know, you've eaten in Ramadan? How many dates? Five? The entire month of Ramadan? Probably maybe, if you count maybe five a day, it is five a day, I think more than that, right? If you remember, at iftar time, sometimes in between snacks, and then, you know, later at suhoor time, probably maybe 10 pieces a day, probably. So that's basically, if you eat 10 a day, can you imagine you will have 20 opportunities of entering al-Jannah and getting yourself away from Jahannam, just the number of dates you've been eating and maybe any kind of sharing with other people. How is that? Let's hear from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's a very famous hadith, a very short hadith. حديث عدي بن حاتم الطائي رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. متفق عليه. In this hadith, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, protect yourself against the fire of hell or hellfire, even if it should be that the giving of a half a date, given in a charity. So he's saying, protect yourself from Jahannam, even by giving half a date. So remember the dates you've been eating in Ramadan? Can you imagine if you had one day, one opportunity as you were eating, someone came late? What did you do? Here you go. So that's a full date now, not just half, the full date. This could be your ticket to Al-Jannah. Maybe you didn't have much, so you split that date and you gave it to the person next to you. This half date that you've given this person could be your shield from Jahannam. And that's one way of giving khairat and giving, doing good deeds. The hadith has a story though. The story is Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, one day, a poor lady, she came begging for food, and she had two little girls with her. So Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, I looked around, I found three dates. She gave it to the woman, to the mother. If you're in position of that mother, what would you do? Share, right? You ain't gonna say, no, I need to take them, to protect them, so I'm gonna eat everything. No. So she gave one to this girl, and one to this girl. By the time she came to the second one to give her her date, and she was about to put the third one in her mouth, what happened? The little girls, while they're still chewing their date, what did they do? She starts climbing on mom's hand, trying to get that extra date. I mean, the mother's as hungry as the kids, right? But kids are kids. So when she looked into the situation, she of course preferred her kids over herself. So she grabbed her own date and she split that. And she gave each one of them half. Aisha was astonished by that sight. She was like, wow, this is a lot. This is too much, subhanAllah. So when she told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya Rasulullah, earlier I had such and such, you know, incident happen in front of my eyes in the house. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to her, اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. Like he said to her that this hadith and this statement means that protect yourself from the hellfire even if it was by giving half a date in charity. There's another narration for the hadith to show you how significant this half a date you give in charity that will be in the day of judgment. In the continuation of the hadith or another narration, the Prophet ﷺ says, ما منكم من أحد إلا سيكلمه ربه ليس بينه وبينه ترجمان. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this narration, Allah will surely speak with every one of you in a manner that suits His majesty, of course, subhanahu wa ta'ala, without any interpreter to translate for Him. So each and every one of us, regardless of what tongue you speak, you'll be standing before your Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala, individually, on your own, and there'll be no translation, no interpretation between Allah azza wa jalla. You're going to speak, Allah will speak to you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, فَيَنْظُرُ أَيْمَنَ مِنْ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمْ وَيَنْظُرُ أَشْأَمَ مِنْ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمْ وَيَنْظُرُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا النَّارَ تِلْقَاءَ وَجْهِهِ فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ وَلَا بِشِقِّ تَمْرَةٍ فَمَنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ فَبِكَلِمَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ. Now, if you were in that position, before I get to the translation, if you're in that position, standing before your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala on your own, what would you do? What would you think at that moment? You're looking for what? Most likely you'll be looking for the exit door, right? Like, oh man, I don't know. So is there any way that I can, you know, get away from here? So you try to look to see if there's anything that can help you on the right side. Anything, anybody. Try to look to the left if there's anything I can have, you know, to help me while I'm standing with Allah Azza wa Jal. You look behind you, look in front of you, look everywhere. So the Prophet said, after he said, فَيَنْضُرُ أَيْمَنَ مِنْهُ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمْ. So this person will look to his right side or her right side, and he will, or she will see nothing but what they have already done, which means of their deeds, good or bad. And then, وَيَنْضُرُ أَشْأَمَ مِنْ, which means look to the left side, فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمْ. Same thing, you won't see anything except what you've already done. And then he said, وَيَنْضُرُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا النَّارَ تِلْقَاءَ وَجِهِ. Then this person will look facing, you know, him, that direction, and he sees the hellfire. Like the scary part, basically. So if there's nothing to help, that will be the destination. The Prophet ﷺ, then he said, فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ وَلَا بِشِقِّ تَمْرَ. Therefore, guard yourself. Shield yourself from Jahannam, even if it was by giving half a date in charity. Some of us might say, Ya Shaykh, wallah, even that date I don't have. So in this case, the Prophet ﷺ said, فَمَنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ فَبِكَلِمَةٌ طَيِّبَةٌ. So if you couldn't find anything to give, at least give a good word. Which means be positive. Someone is begging, asking you for something. Ya Shaykh, don't be rude to them. Ya Shaykh, you don't know them, they always, not of your business. That's between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If anyone is asking without really a serious need and just kind of take advantage of the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them on the day of judgment, that the flesh of their face will melt. So that's none of your business. If someone comes and asks you, politely you speak to them. If you don't want them to give here, says, if you don't mind, just go to the office, they will take care of you. If they come to you, they ask you, you don't want to give, just tell them, you know, I don't have anything, I'm so sorry. May Allah make it easy for you. But don't you ever say anything rude to them. What will be kalimatun tayyibah? Not necessarily for the needy people. Even those who are going through a rough time, rough day, whatever, you see them in a bad situation, bad mood, just give them a word of encouragement. Good word will act as a charity on your behalf. So that's that. Many things we could do. And as the Prophet said, the least is half a date. If you couldn't have that, if you didn't have that, then good word. That'll be sufficient, inshallah ta'ala, probably to shield you from Jahannam. Allah protect you all the jama'ah. Question. Okay, dates, because back in the day, they have dates as a staple, you know, food for themselves. How about today? Would a fig count for us? Like, اتَّقُوا النَّارَ وَلَوْ بِشِقِّ fig, half a fig with me, would that count? How about half an apple, ya jama'ah? How about half an apple would count the same thing too? Come on, Jamal, do you have doubts? Don't be so literalist. Don't say no. The Prophet said to be a date. What if someone doesn't eat date? How about half a loaf of bread? Would that count? So the meaning of the hadith is not necessarily to focus on the date itself. It's to focus on the amount of charity, which means something you've been considering insignificant, but with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not what you give, it's what's in the heart that made you give, the intention that made this so valuable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to raise this for you. So that's what it means. So like a bottle of water, for example. It's so hot out there, jama'ah. So hot out there. So every now and then, if someone, for example, wants to make a charity, akhi, keep in your car, you know, bottles of water. As you drive around, you see people in the street and they're just kind of like, you know, yeah, and soaking in sweat and just give them a bottle of water. There you go. How about, you know, ice cream? You buy ice cream and give it to the people. Like give it outside the masjid after Isha, for example. Why you take permission from Tariq first? All right? So eventually, you do something like that, it will count. And I guess all of you have been to Hajj. You've seen that, right? A lot of people in the Hajj, they see people, subhanAllah, they give ice cream and bottles of water for free. Everybody's trying to collect these half a day kind of, you know, of charities. So make sure that you collect your collection, inshallah, gather your collection bin Allah Azza wa Jal. Begin with half a day. and grow it big بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shield you all from Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you all people of Jannah, ya رب العالمين. Any question? Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So basically for you, half of it is not challenging because it's easy to give, right? So does it mean that I have to do something so great and big so I can, so it counts for me? The answer is it doesn't matter what you give. What if at that moment, you're rich, you're a millionaire. At that moment, all what you had in your pocket is $1 and someone asks you for money. As a millionaire, what would you say? A dollar? Come on, that's nothing. Maybe next time. You don't give a dollar. But subhanAllah, when you look at you're giving for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, then just do it. Just give it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you don't have to put yourself into hardship to get the greater reward. Like, no, I need to first of all collect $10,000 so I can give in charity, inshallah ta'ala. And therefore, I'm not going to give $5 here, $10 here. No, give. Just give. And when the time comes for a bigger challenge and you're up to it, bismillah, you can participate. But never go on giving the least, such as half a date. Wallahu alam. خير إن شاء الله تعالى. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Reminder, inshallah, about the programs with Nilaz. Just a quick actually reminder, there's a new announcement here for you guys. Next week, inshallah, Wednesday, with Nilaz.